handling to Instant Hair Plus, Box 1313, Burbank, California. Call now, 1-800-545-4400.
Talk television doesn't get any better than Southland Today. Weekdays at 11:30 on 56 KDOC.
And now, it's time for Hot Seat Highlights with Wally George. Stand by for a hard-hitting commentary by Wally on the issues of the day. And you'll be seeing highlights from the most explosive and controversial hot seat shows over the past 9 years. And now, here he is, the original voice of controversy and conservatism on television, Wally George.
Yes, Wally's back. It's Wally Wonderful, better known as Mr. America, as I carry on the Reagan Revolution every night here on our Hot Seat Highlights. I am showing you highlights from the past decade of my Hot Seat show. In just a couple of weeks now, we'll be celebrating our 11th year anniversary show here for Hot Seat. Now, what we do is, on this program every night at midnight, we show you highlights from the past 10 years of my program, and then following me, it's the Downey Show from 12 to Morton Downey from 12:30 to 1. So be with us from 12 until 1 every night. Saturday night, of course, 11 until 12. It is Hot Seat with my live studio audience and all that kind of stuff. So be with us 6 times a week. Okay, I got some really good stuff picked out for you for tonight's program, taken from the past decade. Here's something you'll probably get a kick out of, I hope. Let's roll it.
And David, will you introduce our first guest?
Okay, first up today, Wally, we have the host of Video One from K-Rock Radio, Richard Blaze.
Yeah! All
right. Yeah. Okay.
I see that you've gone out there and bribed my audience.
That's right. Well, they know that we're going to be giving away K-Rock t-shirts.
Hey, Richard, hold on. I've always wanted one of those. May I have one of those t-shirts? May I have one, Richard?
I hope you can get one over the wig.
Here we go, Richard. I've always wanted one of these t-shirts. Get out of here.
We've also got some U2 albums to give away.
Look how he's bribing my audience.
Wally, I brought the U2 along because I saw on Hot Seat Hotline, which I watch every day, I must admit.
Thank you very
much. You said U2 were a bunch of devil worshippers.
They are. They're terrible.
No, they're Christians. Three of the four admit they're Christians.
You're saying I'm wrong?
You're wrong.
Wally is never wrong.
No, I mean, they've got songs on
the song. Don't try to prove it to me now. I don't want any proof.
Absolutely.
We're getting beyond the issue. The reason I have you down here now is your station is one of the stations that is being criticized.
Right.
Now, the FCC is cracking down on what they call raunch radio, shock radio. And I say it's about time. I say the FCC should crack down. There's a lot of nonsense, a lot of really filth and sexual innuendo that little kids are listening to. And I say it's about time that the FCC crack down on these filthy radio stations.
What if the FCC crack down and make mistakes like you did and crack down on the wrong stations? You think you two are devil worshippers when they're in fact Christians singing songs like I Will Follow. What happens if they make mistakes like you did?
The FCC only is cracking down now because they've received so many complaints from all over the country. Your own station, I was on a show called Loveline on his stupid station. And I was frankly amazed at how filthy the conversation got on that program with that idiot poor man. He's talking dirty to little kids, 11 and 12 years old, saying things about condoms and all that kind of stuff. It's ridiculous.
Yeah. He's just trying to prevent the spread of AIDS. And
he came on my show and blew a condom up like a balloon.
Well, he's got the strength to blow one up, Wally.
But, Richard.
Yeah.
How can you support people like Howard Stern back in New York? This guy on K-Power, Jay Thomas, and many others who come on the air and they say dirty things, very dirty things, play dirty records, and you had the audacity to come out and on your station, and I hate to have to say this on television, but I'm going to say it, so you can, and it's not funny, and I want you laughing at this. There was a song out, there was a song out that was called Walk Like an Egyptian.
Right.
And K-Rock, now I hate to say this, and if you have kids watching, have them leave the room, but K-Rock came out and thought it was funny, and they changed the name of Walk Like an Egyptian to Walk With an Erection.
Wally, I think the basic problem here is that you haven't had an erection 20 years.
You see how dirty you are? Your dirty, filthy mouth should be erased from radio.
I'm just saying what you said. You said the word erection first. I'm repeating you. Could you have been wrong to say the word erection?
I was trying to explain the kind of things that you're doing on K-Rock Radio and other stations across this nation, and the FCC has the right to censor that kind of thing.
Well, prior to this irrational decision from the FCC, there were 7 words that you couldn't say on the radio. I have a list if anyone wants
to. No,
it
you're
later,
not going to do them here. No one
in the business has ever said those words and kept their job. They'd be fired immediately, unless, of course, you drop something on your foot and you go, oh, you know, then you say it by mistake, right? But those 7 words were the guideline. Now the FCC said anything can be interpreted as obscene if it offends. Well, now, surely jerkette or jerk could offend someone, so you could be obscene.
That's not an obscene. Obscenity, you know what they're talking about. Like I just said a few minutes ago, the way you changed the word, the name of that song, and the things that you do on the air. Everyone knows what obscene is, saying dirty words over the air, trying to turn things around into being obscene and filthy and degrading, double entendres on the air. You know, it wouldn't be so bad, but 10, 11, 12-year-old kids are tuned into stations like yours and others all over the country, and the FCC has finally said enough is enough, and I say they're right. What do you think?
Well, what about the adults that want some fun humor, then?
What's that?
What about the adults that want some fun humor? Are we going to say we can't say something that's fun, something risque to entertain?
Why do you have to be risque? It's not risque, it's dirty. These are public airwaves, Richard, public. And when the radio turns, when the people turn on that radio, they never know what they're going to hear. They can have kids in the car. They turn that radio on, and you or Poor Man or Howard Stern or whoever are coming on the, Rick Dees, come on the air with his Willard Waterman unzipping his pants on the air. Now, this kind of thing.
But there's 83 radio signals coming to Los Angeles, including KLAC, so they've got a choice.
They don't have a choice because you never know what you're going to hear when you turn on the radio.
But once you hear it once, why go back to that station?
But then you've already been offended. It's too late.
And you're corrupted for life because you've heard the word erection?
But no, wait. A lot more words than that, Richard, and you know it. You see, what happens is, what bothers me is these raunchy schlock radio stations, not rock schlock radio stations, they will do anything to get ratings. And I say obscenity is no way to get ratings, especially when kids are listening. You see, I'm sure that you're one of the liberal lunatics, and all the liberals...
What could I say?
Hey, the liberals in this country are always screaming about air pollution. Well, I'm screaming about pollution of the airwaves. How about that, gang?
You know, it seems to be the right-wing Republicans, such as yourself and the church groups, that have brought this movement about. And yet, earlier in the show, we were talking about Jim Bacon. Now, this is a guy who's committed adultery, being accused from within the church of homosexual relationships.
Accused.
Who is this kind of person to point the finger at a radio station?
Well, wait, he's been accused, Richard. You guys have actually done it, or the FCC wouldn't be taking this kind of action.
But he has admitted to adultery, and he's admitted to paying blackmail.
Well, he did not know. He did not say it was blackmail.
Well, he paid her not to talk. Now, that seems to me to be blackmail.
Well, she's saying, but why are we getting to Jim Baker?
Because it's his kind of person that has motivated the FCC to crack down on radio stations.
He hasn't said a thing about the FCC. Jim Baker hasn't said it. It's the moral people in America who have risen up in
indignation. But the moral majority aren't.
The moral people in this country have risen up against
Wally, grow
like
up.
Yours.
Look at your church groups. Look at your religion. Look at yourself. It's not moral. We're all the same. You're hiding behind a sham of republicanism.
I am not.
You're on the way out. Reagan's on his way out. Look at Iran. He was great. He was great for 4 years. Then he surrounded himself with incompetence.
What you are doing, Blade, and people like you, you're trying to brainwash the youth of America.
No, we're trying to wake them up.
No, you're
trying to say, if you want to be a Republican, great. If you
want to
be a Christian, great. But if you want to be free thinking, then great, be yourself.
No, wait a minute. What you're doing with this obscenity, saying dirty things, praying.
We don't say dirty things.
Keep your big mouth shut for a minute. What I'm saying is, by what you're doing, a lot of young kids listen to you guys on the radio, and they try to emulate you. You're heroes to a lot of young kids, and what you do, they emulate. When you talk dirty and filthy on the air and say sexual innuendos and all these kind of things, they copy you, and I say you are doing a disservice. You are brainwashing American youth badly, and I want to get rid of it. I'll be right back.
Alright, enough of this. Okay, I'll talk.
Don't tell him!
For the lowest auto insurance rates.
Call Survival. For any car, any driver, Survival offers the lowest rates and best service. 1-800-441-5533. You tried the rest, now try the best. Call Survival now.
Can you tell which one of these women is wearing a wig?
They all are, and so am I. Why? Because today's wigs are fashionable, so convenient, and give you the freedom to always look your best. The freedom to be active and beautiful. Now enjoy high-quality wigs at incredibly low prices, right here in the Paula Young catalog of affordable fashion wigs. Paula Young, America's largest wig company with over 750 style and color combinations, all 100% guaranteed.
They treat you like a number one customer.
Paula Young makes me feel terrific.
I'm not so bad looking after all for an old dame of almost 74.
Call now for your free catalog and get these coupons to save up to $50 off your very first order. Discover for yourself the freedom of wearing wigs. Call now.
To get your free wig catalog, call 1-800-892-9997. That's 1-800-892-9997. There's no obligation, so call now.
Hey guys, have you found out about Patty Murphy's in Santa Ana? What a great time you'll have there. Terrific all-star entertainment featuring some of the most beautiful girls in the state of California on stage for your entertainment. It's fun time all the time. Ask for a free autographed photo of yours truly with your admission. Perfect place for a bachelor party. Patty Murphy's, 2920 West Warner in Santa Ana, or give them a call, the number on your screen. We'll see you for fun at Patty Murphy's in Santa Ana.
Welcome back. Wally George here with Richard Blade, our guest. We're talking about the FCC crackdown on obscenity on some of these schlock rock radio stations. And you know what? A lot of you guys, Richard, are saying, well, Wally, what about the First Amendment? What the FCC chairman said is, and I agree, when they wrote the First Amendment, they did not mean that to protect obscenity. Am I right? How do you answer that?
Well, I've got a list of new words that are considered unacceptable to say, and one of the words is hot monkey love. I mean, I don't even understand what hot monkey love is, Wally. I mean, why would anyone say that you can't say hot monkey love or hemorrhoid on the radio?
Oh, well, that's filthy.
I mean, you can't.
You don't talk about that.
I mean, what is wrong with saying something like time of the month? That's another word you can't say. That's from Billboard magazine.
Why in the world?
Well, there goes the seven words we can't say.
Why would you want to talk about hemorrhoids?
That's what I'm talking about. Why would you go on there talking about hemorrhoids, for heaven's sake?
Well, it's better than saying that someone's a pain in the ass.
You see how you talk? You see how you talk? I hope people at home are listening to his foul mouth, because the FCC wants to put a zipper on his mouth and others all across America, and I'm all in favor of that. I say this. I'm going even further. I say this. If you guys don't clean up your act at K-Rock and the other stations, I give you 6 months, and I hope the FCC pulls the plug and knocks you guys right off the air. How do you say that?
Well, I think, you know, I really believe if we say one of the seven dirty words, which George Carlin did on stage, and no professional radio announcer would, I think we deserve to be taken off the air. I think a DJ that advocates drugs or driving when drunk deserves to be taken off the air. But I think a DJ that gets on with a sense of humor and a little risque double entendre, Johnny Carson does all the time, why not?
But Johnny Carson is not playing to young kids. You know the kids that are listening to K-Rock, a lot of them are 9, 10, 11, and 12 years old. Why aren't you guys, why do you have to be risque? Why do you have to be double entendre?
Money.
That does not belong, yeah, money, you're right. The guy said it, get my hat, yeah. That guy is right. You guys are like a bunch of prostitutes. You'll do anything. Yeah. You'll sell yourselves out.
Well, talking about prostitutes and money and ratings, how come during ratings periods you always get prostitutes on hot seat to talk to them?
I bring prostitutes on my show to tell them how degrading they are. I bring you on to tell you how degrading you are.
But you keep bringing more and more prostitutes.
You know, I have to keep telling them. I want to get my message across. David, do you have a question to ask?
Yeah. What Johnny Carson says maybe can be described as risque. The stuff that we're talking about that you're saying and these others couldn't be called risque.
It's dirty.
Total, absolute obscenity. And so on. Now, why? How far can this stuff possibly go?
Well,
I mean, stuff that was unthinkable a few years ago is now routine.
That's right.
Can it go any farther?
In the East Coast, they are a lot more risque than us out here on the West Coast.
Well, you're pretty raunchy. I want to tell you that.
I have to tell you this. A DJ by the name of Howard Stern in New York did a large search.
Oh! You can't say that. I'm going to have to bleep that off of this show. You can't say that.
Well, he found the guy. I haven't got his number for you or anything. But
this guy is...
Oh, I mean, the other thing is, you know, with or without radio, some records which you might consider raunchy make it to number one. The Beastie Boys made number one in America before radio really jumped all over it. Now, I got tickets to give away to the Beastie Boys tonight. So I'll give these away in a bit to probably the best question or something. By the way, if anyone wants to know what the Beastie Boys will look like in 20 years, we've got three of them sitting right at the front with dark glasses on. Looking great as well.
Now, you see, here's the whole thing that I'm saying. This FCC ruling cracking down on schlock rock radio, what it is, it's simply a lasso thrown around a raging bull, Richard, that is completely out of control. The Federal Communications Commission would never have acted if you guys hadn't gone off the deep end. Hold it in the audience. But you guys, you see, there was deregulation of radio. They took the restrictions off of radio stations, and they said, let the stations censor themselves. But you guys, like K-Rock and the rest across the country, you guys didn't have that kind of decency. You didn't know how to regulate yourselves. And so the FCC says, okay, these stations, these disc jockeys are not going to police themselves. So we're going to put the restraints back, and we're going to force these stations to clean up their act.
Painting your home can seem like a back-breaking chore that never ends. And paying to have it done every few years can be expensive and aggravating. Well, now there's a revolutionary way to end that hassle forever with Sears authorized Tough Guard 99 exterior coating. In as little as 3 days, your home can have a beautiful appearance that's so tough, it's guaranteed for as long as you own your home.
Call right now and you'll receive a free in-home consultation and estimate.
Tough Guard 99 is many times thicker than paint. It lasts virtually forever.
Sears Tough Guard 99 is guaranteed against chipping, peeling, and flaking for as long as you own your home. Throw your paintbrushes away. You won't need them anymore. And Tough Guard 99 is environmentally safe. It contains no lead or mercury, so it protects and beautifies without the health risk of many lead paints. With Sears Tough Guard 99, you'll be proud to come home every day. But that's just the beginning. Sears' unique Tough Guard 99 can be mixed to any color you desire. Your home will transform from this to this, and it's guaranteed to stay that way. And the best part? The guarantee is backed by Sears, America's most trusted name around the house. You can be sure the job will be done right the first time, professionally, and that Sears will be there if you ever need service. Plus, call right away and take advantage of this great offer.
Call 1-800-238-4800 right now, and you'll receive a free in-home consultation and estimate on coating your home with Tough Guard 99.
So if you've got better ways to spend your time and money,
pick up the phone and call 1-800-238-4800 now. You'll receive a free in-home consultation and estimate on beautifying your home while saving time, effort, and money. Sears installed home improvements have over 1 million satisfied customers and counting. So call now. 1-800-238-4800.
Now it's time to introduce our next guest on the program. And, you know, there are a lot of phony, flaky managers in the town of Hollywood, and I think we have one of them here that I've discovered. He manages models in Hollywood, and he calls himself Jed Brotherman. Let's hear it for flaky Jed Brotherman. All right. Now, Brotherman, you are a models manager. Is that?
I provide a very basic service. I discover girls that should be models. I turn them into models, and perhaps I collect a buck here or there after I've made them into great models.
Oh yeah, sure. You can't collect a buck here and there.
Now,
what kind of models do you handle, Jed?
I work with whatever kinds of models the consumer of the model wishes to look at.
Yeah.
All strictly clean, of course, legitimate.
Yeah, now this is one of your models here, right?
Yeah, this happens to be my pet. This is my favorite model.
Oh, boy. What is your name?
My name is Lily.
Your name is Lily?
Lily.
And you are his star client, huh?
Yes, I'm proud to say I am.
Soon to be a superstar.
Well, she's going to be a real superstar, isn't she, guys? What? Hey, this is his best client. I hate to see his worst client. Now,
he's got something against women. Don't
let me ask you this.
He's clearly got something against women.
Let me ask you this. Did you pay this guy any money? Why are you looking at me that way? Do you always look like that? Hey, hold it. You are awake, aren't you? All right, now listen. Did you pay this guy over here any money to handle you as a manager? Did you pay him any money?
No, I advance him fees for the expenses that he has to put out.
You terrifically expensive fees. Business, Mr. George.
You advance him fees.
I advance him fees, but it's necessary to put me forward in this business.
Yeah, okay.
In order to create and develop a superstar, there are certain expenses.
How long has he represented you?
6 months.
And how much would you say offhand you've advanced him in fees?
That's not what's important, Mr.
George. Is it important? Oh, yeah! Give us a rough estimate. How much money have you advanced this flake over here?
Well, considering how much he's done, I mean, it's not that.
But how much about?
About
$3,500. Hey, don't you realize it's against the law for managers to take money?
Advancing fees. These are expenditures. I've got to travel to Italy, all over Europe, in order to promote her correctly.
Yeah, sure.
I've got to throw huge parties, Mr.
Hold on.
Expensive business.
You've advanced him $3,500. Have you ever got any work?
That's not the point.
It is. Is it the point?
Yeah!
point. It is the point. Have you ever, has he gotten you one?
You don't become a success overnight, sir. Shut you know that.
Now, hold on. I want to, let's get to the nitty gritty here, right?
If you're balding or have thinning hair, wouldn't you rather look like this? Introducing Instant Hair Plus, the amazing hair thickener that gets rid of bald spots and thickens your hair in an instant. Instant Hair Plus's microfine formula adheres to even the finest hairs to thicken them and fill in bald spots.
What I like about Instant Hair Plus is it looks totally natural. Even up close, nobody can tell that I'm using it.
When my wife first saw it, she was amazed at the difference, and we both think it's a miracle.
Instant Hair Plus is easy to use and is not a paint-on or cover-up. It clings to your hair and actually builds it up thicker and thicker right before your eyes. Use any hairspray to set, brush, and you're ready to go. Now, can you tell where the bald spot was?
There's nothing to it. It just takes a few seconds, and I'm set for the day. I could not believe how full it actually made your hair look. I never want to be without it.
And Instant Hair Plus is not just for men.
I always thought thinning hair was something you just had to live with. Instant Hair Plus is wonderful.
I've been using a product like this on the stars in Hollywood for 30 years. Fortunately, now it's available to you.
Instant Hair Plus shampoos out and comes in 5 natural colors, one just right for you. Although many think that Instant Hair Plus is worth its weight in gold, during this special TV offer, you pay only $19.95. Try it for 30 days risk-free. If you don't agree that Instant Hair Plus is the next best thing to growing hair, just return it for a prompt refund. Say goodbye to thinning hair and bald spots. Look younger and feel better. Order Instant Hair Plus now.
Use your credit card and call 1-800-545-4400. That's 1-800-545-4400. Or send $19.95 plus $4.50 shipping and handling to Instant Hair Plus, Box 1313, Burbank, California. That's Instant Hair Plus, Box 1313, Burbank, California. But for credit card orders, call now 1-800-545-4400. That's 1-800-545-4400.
Okay, gang, don't forget now to join me every Sunday now for my new Wally George Great American Radio Special on KWIZ, KWIZ, Quiz FM, 96.7, Santa Ana, Los Angeles. I do my comments on what's happening around the nation, open the mailbag, read your letters, and have some VIP guests with me in the studio. So join me every Sunday, 10 a.m., KWIZ, 96.7 FM, the Wally George Great American Radio Special. And if you should want to write to me, here's my address coming up on the screen. Wally George, P.O. Box 787, Hollywood, California, 90078. Write to me. I will read some of your letters on my radio show in the mailbag segment. If you want a free autographed picture personally autographed to you, let me know, and I'll mail one out to you just as soon as I possibly can. We do read all the letters. We answer them as soon as we can. And if you have a snapshot of yourself, put that in there, and I'll put you on my bulletin board. P.O. Box 787, Hollywood, California, 90078. Write to me. I do want to see you. I want to hear from you. That's all the time we're going to have for our program here tonight. God bless you all. God bless America.
If you happen to see this program, you are entitled to a free copy of Mary Baker Eddy's book, Science and Health, simply by calling 495-4628, weekdays from 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. The program was under the sponsorship of First Church of Christ Scientist Laguna Beach, and we would appreciate knowing if you saw this program. Thank you.
Hi.
I love Wally George.
I love Wally George.
He is the coolest stud in Anaheim.
He is the coolest stud in Anaheim.
And I watch him every night
at
midnight.
I watch him every night at midnight.
And Saturdays at 11.
And Saturdays at 11.
I love him dearly.
I love him dearly.
I want his body.
I want his body.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Hey, she did good. Hey, print that one, Hoshi.
That was great. Give me a kiss right there on the cheek.
Join Ben, Adam, Hoss, Little Joe, and of course, Hop Sing for dinner. Weeknights at 7 on 56 KDOC.
And now it's time for Hot Seat Highlights with Wally George. Stand by for hard-hitting comments by Wally on the issues of the day. And you'll be seeing highlights from the most explosive and controversial hot seat shows over the past 10 years. And now, here he is, the original voice of controversy and conservatism on television, Wally George.
Thank you very much. Welcome, everybody. Here we go again. Last night I was kidding you when I said that Michael Jackson was going to be on the show as a special in-person guest in studio. Tonight I'm not kidding you. In studio, this is still ratings time, right, Hoshi?
Yes.
Right. In studio tonight, folks, call all your friends. In studio, sitting right beside me in just a very few minutes, Bill Clinton, Hillary, and Chelsea are going to be sitting here talking to me, and not only Bill, Hillary, and Chelsea, but also Sox the cat. They're all going to be here. You know, Hoshi, I think I'd rather interview Sox than any of the other three. Okay, I'm only kidding. Just thought I'd do with that. Hype the radio. Okay, we're here every night, Monday through Friday. Highlights from the past 11 years of my hot seat show, Saturday nights 11 until 12. Here's some highlights right now from one of our past shows. Watch.
And now, Bill, hold it down, gang. And now, Bill, Ludicrous Larry is back again, I see, if you want to introduce him.
He is. Ludicrous Larry is back with a more ludicrous idea than even his last one. Now he's gone off the deep end with regard to guns. He doesn't think that anybody should have a weapon at all for self-defense or anything. It's the ludicrous Larry Rice.
Larry Rice, come on.
No, I don't need a weapon because I'm a stud. I'm smarter than you, better
You're a
than you.
Stud?
I'm oh. than you. But you know what? Wimps like you are the kind of people that need guns.
Don't get smart with me.
You're the kind of guy that needs to carry protection around. That's the only kind of protection you probably need too, Mr.
Hey,
George.
Hey, pal.
You know what I mean? You know what I mean?
Well, shut up,
you know
moron.
What I'm talking about?
Hey, listen, hold on.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
If this guy's a stud, Pee-wee Herman is Sylvester Stallone. Now, wait a minute. The reason we're here now, moron, every time a tragedy strikes, and we all hate to see people blown away by tragedies, but every time somebody shoots somebody, people like Larry jump on the bandwagon and they say, oh, boy, now we gotta ban all guns. I say, Larry, we're not going to ban guns. I say, in America, every American citizen, every law-abiding citizen should be able to buy any weapon he wants to buy.
Yeah.
How do you answer that?
And I suppose it's okay for them just to pack them around right on their hip in a holster or something so they can just...
Absolutely right.
Would you trust these wimps out here with a bunch of guns? Oh.
The only weapon I need to subdue this moron is a cream puff. Yeah! Now, Larry...
You know, the truth is, if you turn a bunch of guns loose in this country, unregistered guns, you're going to have nothing but wanton killing, blood in the streets.
We already have blood in the streets.
We already have blood in the streets. Like you want.
We already have blood in the streets. Shut up a minute. What I'm saying is, we already have blood in the streets. We have gang members shooting and killing people with their guts lying in the streets. Right now, Larry, the way you want to do it is take the guns away from us law-abiding citizens so the only ones who will have guns are the criminals, and I say that's wrong!
You know what you don't seem to realize is that people aren't very predictable sometimes. You know, how would you feel if everybody out in this audience had a gun strapped
on? I love it.
How would you like to go to the ball game and not know, you know, 50,000 people there and there's 20,000 guns in the stands? How'd you like to go to a dance and bump into somebody next to you by mistake and have them whip out a gun and start shooting?
Oh, don't be stupid.
That's what you're going to get. What's going to happen. You have it your way. It's an absolutely stupid idea. You don't ever think of the consequences. You don't ever think of the consequences.
I'm thinking about the people.
No. Wait a minute.
Shut up.
We have enough freeway shootings. You know, if everybody cruising down the freeway had a gun in their car, before you know it, we'd have civil war in this country.
I'm telling you this.
That's stupid.
I'm telling you this. You're the only...
Hey, shut up while I'm talking. I want those guys to shut up. If all these bozos out here had guns on, you know what would happen? Before you know it, you'd have shots flying around in this place.
No, hold on.
You're just not realistic.
You gotta be realistic. I'm being realistic. I'm saying this.
Wait a minute.
With the crime and corruption going around, with the gangs shooting people down, innocent victims, I say we law-abiding citizens have the right to have guns and protect ourselves.
Larry, you have security guards. Would you shut up? Shut them up. You have security guards right here just to keep peace and keep order. Well, now, what in the world would you need in this studio, for instance, if people were strapping on guns?
Hold on. What I'm saying is,
how would you like to walk into a bar where people are drinking alcohol
and
everybody had a gun strapped on?
What I'm saying is...
That's not realistic.
Wait a minute. What I'm saying is, every... If the criminals knew that all of us law-abiding citizens did not have guns, we're not armed, they'd be after us twice as much as they are now. I say not only should we be able to have handguns strapped on with holsters, we should be able to buy Uzis, AK-47s, and bazookas. I'll be right back.
Need a good job? You better get the proper education. I want you to go over there to New Bridge College in Tustin. You can become part of the demand of the legal and health care team at New Bridge College, a fully accredited school offering courses which have been ranked among the top 10 careers of the 90s. Learn to be a paralegal assistant, surgical technologist, medical laboratory technician, or medical biller or medical office manager. They feature job placement service after graduation, financial assistance available to qualified applicants at New Bridge College.
Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee.
Everyone should visit the Holy Land. You can, with Pat Boone in Israel, O Blessed Israel. The first home video feature to combine the timeless beauty of places where Jesus walked. Bethlehem, Jerusalem, the Galilee, and more, guided by Pat, with some of the most popular hymns ever composed.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound.
Follow Pat to where the Sermon on the Mount was heard, to the history-filled Jordan River, into the Garden of Gethsemane, and within the walls of the world's holiest city. Classic songs of faith, and a special Holy Land booklet. Plus, Pat's brilliant performance of Exodus from majestic Masada overlooking the Dead Sea. Cherish this new video masterpiece in stereo with family and friends forever. Yes, everyone can visit the Holy Land with Pat Boone. Don't miss it.
Order Pat Boone's Israel, O Blessed Israel, a beautiful video gift of sight and sound. Only $19.95 plus shipping, not sold in stores. Call free 1-800-533-8787. Use Visa or MasterCard, but call now 1-800-533-8787.
We're back, and we're talking to this ludicrous Larry Rice. You know, Larry wants to ban all guns because, you know, they kill people. Well, you know, Larry, I saw an article in the paper just the other day where a man killed his wife with a baseball bat. So should we ban baseball bats? Huh?
That's the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard of. Baseball bats are made for another purpose. Guns are made for killing. Guns are made for killing.
No, they're not.
No, we can't ban everything.
They're not made for killing. They're made for hunting and for defense, right?
Well, and what is defense? Defense is killing.
Defending yourself.
No, we can't even control
people. Defending yourself, Larry. Defending yourself from a maniac.
Would you be quiet?
No, it's my show.
Well, then let me talk. You seem to forget that people are not controllable. We can't have vast crowds of people. I suppose you'd like to walk into Disneyland with your family, and we got guys walking around with AK-47s, right? And you're just ushering your little children into the Pirates of the Caribbean, right?
I'm saying, Larry.
Totally secure, knowing that these jerks walking around Disneyland could explode any time and start shooting everybody in sight.
What I'm saying is these criminals are roaming the streets with their AK-47s and their rifles and pistols, and we should not be sitting ducks completely unarmed, should we?
No!
Do you know, Larry, hold on a minute.
Okay.
Larry, hold on a minute. Do you know millions of people die every year from automobile accidents? Millions more.
No, don't start that.
More people die from automobile accidents than from guns, don't they?
Yeah!
You
want to ban automobiles, Larry?
Right.
You want to ban automobiles?
But we have regulations about automobiles, right? If you drive too fast, you get a ticket. If you have a medical problem, you don't get a license.
Same thing with a gun.
Or you're going to take their license away, I suppose, if they kill too many people.
Sit down.
Okay.
So
a guy that's got a gun, if he kills too many people, you just revoke his killing license.
What I'm saying is,
you have to be reasonable.
Wait a minute. I'm saying this. What I'm saying is this: we're talking about freedom here. When you're driving a car, you have the freedom to drive an automobile. You may kill someone with that automobile, but you have the freedom to drive it, and you also have the freedom to own a gun.
Yeah!
You talk about, it's really interesting to me that if a guy were to walk down the street and smoke a marijuana cigarette, for instance. Now, I know that most of the guys in your audience probably been smoking marijuana right before the show.
Oh, get out of here.
But you know what? You wouldn't let him smoke a marijuana cigarette, but you'd let him haul out a loaded gun in public. Can't you imagine?
I'm saying adults, 18 and over, adults.
Oh, 18 and over. How about a mental patient? I suppose a mental patient could have a gun too, right? Want a bunch of freak over?
Obviously, he's a mental patient, isn't he?
I suppose that...
You're an obvious mental case.
What about a convicted criminal? Could they have guns, too?
I'm telling you.
You want everybody to have a gun and we could have... This isn't Dodge City. This is Anaheim. This is California. This is the world. This isn't the streets of Laredo. Wild West.
What I'm saying, Larry, it's the same way with an automobile. If you drive an automobile responsibly, you can keep your license. If you handle a gun correctly, you keep your gun.
What you don't understand is that the guns are manufactured by major companies. They're not manufactured in somebody's garage.
Well, you don't understand, Larry.
Shut up! If it was against law to manufacture those guns, then we wouldn't have them. They wouldn't exist. What are you looking at?
They're just shut up.
If it was against the law to manufacture guns, oh, you're a real stud, aren't you, there, Bill?
Will you shut up? Will you shut up? I'm talking now.
But hold on. You're just not being realistic, Wally. You see, you can't make people act the way you want to act.
Well,
you know what you're going to do?
I'm going to answer you right now. I'm going to answer you.
How about
you? Banning? Larry, I'm answering you. Shut up a minute. Shut up. My show. Banning handguns does nothing to solve the problem. The criminals will still have the handguns, and the only thing that will change is it'll go to the black market, and people will not only be dealing in drugs, they'll be dealing in black market guns, so it's not going to solve a damn thing.
They won't be dealing with black market.
Oh.
You see, You see, you compare drugs, for instance, to guns. Well, I'm sorry, Wally, but drugs are a consumable quantity. You know, a guy doesn't get hooked on a gun and have to have a bunch of guns every day. He might do that on cocaine or drugs, right? But there's going to be no black market in guns because once a guy's got one, he's not going to go looking for another. But what you will have, you'll have gunfights at every college football game.
I say this, Larry.
At high school football games. At every dance.
I say
at every teen center.
Larry,
on the subway.
Larry.
You want a bunch of Bernard Getzes running around.
Larry, hold on a minute. Hold on. There are thousands of families today who are quivering in their homes, afraid to go on the streets, afraid someone's going to break into their home, some gang member, some punk, and they're unarmed. Think how much safer they would feel if they were sitting in their home with an AK-47.
But that's not what you want. You don't want guns in the home. You want guns out on the street.
In holsters.
This isn't the Old West. I mean, can't you realize? What did you have in the home? You'd have showdowns out here on the San Diego freeway?
We have the right. Hey, hold on.
You know, you...
Wait, hold on. Larry,
You probably need a gun to protect yourself.
Wait a minute, Larry.
I got that, buddy.
Larry.
Oh. You need to carry a gun, don't you?
You talk big. You yell big. You talk big. But you would never meet me physically, only verbally. Because you're a panty waste.
You gotta be...
You're a panty waste.
You know what?
To meet beautiful women, then call 1-900-84-INTRO, where you can hear messages from women in your area tonight. And you may place your own personal ad so women may call you. And you can exchange private messages using your free voicemail box. So call the INTRO line exclusively for Southern Californians at 1-900-84-INTRO at only 98 cents per minute.
We all face uncertainties in our life, not knowing what tomorrow may bring, but it doesn't have to be that way. The Psychic Center is the friend of thousands of people just like you. If you're facing difficult times in your life, over 100 accredited, spiritually gifted psychics are waiting to help you decide what direction to follow. The Psychic Center is truly a premier psychic service and is trusted by the Hollywood stars. Now you have a choice. One phone call can make a difference in the rest of your life. Call 1-800-642-TELL.
I want to introduce you to a beautiful, clean, friendly restaurant in Fountain Valley. I love it there. It's the Magnolia Cafe on Warner at Magnolia in Fountain Valley. They serve wonderful, quality, home-cooked food with economic prices. Come in for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Pick up a free autograph photo of yours truly when you come into Magnolia Cafe and ask for the Wally Special. You'll love the array of wonderful things at wonderful prices at the Magnolia Cafe, Warner at Magnolia in Fountain Valley. Say hi to Albert.
Dick Loudon always knows the right thing to say.
Okay.
Beep. Nimrodi, oh my God.
It gotta be me.
New Hearts, weeknights at 6:30, only on 56 KDOC.
My name, Downey. The channel, 56. My home, KDOC. It's in L.A., Monday through Friday. Join us.
Tune in to Downey, weeknights at 12:30 a.m., only on 56 KDOC.
Welcome back to Hot Seat. In case you just joined us, sitting on my right, that is not David. hey, how many think that maybe we should have Becky replace? No, we would never do that.
No. Now, Becky, we were discussing Hugh Hefner and all that.
Uh-huh.
Another thing that I have to say that I can't believe this. Hefner had the audacity and the gall to pay $1 million to that Bow Wow Jessica Hahn. Come on. Would he pay Jessica Hahn $1 million to pose semi-naked in Playboy? Isn't that kind of ludicrous?
Yeah, you got me on that one, Wally. I can't answer you.
She really is. And number one, bimbo, isn't she? Okay. Now, you also, I understand, you have a poster also out.
Yeah, I've got a couple of them, actually. But
is this one?
That's one of them, yeah.
All right. Okay, gang. Now you see.
And see you, Wally. Come on, Wally.
See what she's doing? She's anything she can to make money off of her body. Is that ludicrous or what?
Yeah.
Now let me see what. Oh, Becky, this is terrifying. I don't think I should show this to the audience. What do you think? Well, all right. There it is. Becky, let me tell you something. I want to register my protest for this ludicrous poster, and here it is. Much for your poster. What do you think about that? All right, now,
well, he doesn't have to do that. I just shot a new one last week. It'll be better than that one. So
you shot another poster
last week, brand new Becky poster.
And it's better than that one?
Oh yeah.
Do you have less clothes on?
I'm wearing a lot less, yeah.
She's wearing less. But Becky, I'll never understand. We've had a lot of girls on this show who wear a lot of hardly any clothes, and they pose naked in magazines. Why do you choose this kind of a life? Why don't you want to be a nice, sweet little girl? I mean, why do you want to be the kind of a girl who runs around naked? What made you decide to do that?
Well, I am a nice, sweet little girl. I just happen to run around naked, too.
Wait. Do you believe sweet little girls run around naked? Do Mom and Dad know that you do this?
Oh, I think they've heard, yeah.
Now, when you get married, will you stop all this nonsense and lead a decent life for a change?
Well, I don't think my life is indecent.
Well, are you going to continue to do this, you know, forever?
Well, as long as my body holds up, sure.
Let's go to the audience. Okay, we have some questioners for you. Can I have your first name and your question?
My name is Kevin, and I was just wondering, is that plastic fashion you're wearing?
Yeah.
Is that a plastic skirt that you have?
It's a plastic.
Okay, over there. Thank you.
Let's see it again.
It has a zipper all the way down the back.
Yeah.
All right, yes, sir. Your first name and your question.
My name is Chris, and I was wondering how much you got paid by Playboy to pose not
naked.
Naked, but as in money-wise.
Yes.
Not anything else, but money.
How much did they pay you to pose naked in Playboy?
Oh, the rates are always different. I mean, I've done so many different features that it varies. I don't even
know.
What's
the most that you've gotten?
I don't know, a couple thousand dollars.
A couple thousand dollars, okay. For all together nude, huh?
You know, I don't know. I think actually that was just for a topless.
Okay, what would you get for an altogether nude?
Probably about $20,000.
$20,000? Yeah! Are you serious?
Yeah,
20,000
sure.
bucks. Okay, next.
Next.
That's it?
20,000. That's a lot of bananas. Okay. Yes, your first name?
Chris.
Yes, Chris.
What month were you in, and is that an edible top?
Wait a minute. Get out of here. Yes, yes.
Hi, Becky. My name is Ty. I got a sore throat.
Hi.
I was wondering what size.
Never mind. Get him out of here. Never mind.
looking to party with a few girls tonight? Then call 1-900-84-GIRLS, where you can hear messages from exciting girls that want to meet you tonight. And leave your own voice message for girls that want to party with you. So what are you waiting for? Call 1-900-84-GIRLS to meet your dream girl tonight. That's 1-900-84-GIRLS, exclusively for Southern Californians at only 180 per minute.
Action. Adventure. Romance.
As a matter of fact, I...
Tell me, Mr. Cartwright.
Bonanza, weeknights at 7, only on 56 KDOC.
Janine woke up in a cold sweat with one thing echoing through her brain. Who is this guy in her bathroom?
Meanwhile, Barry was thinking, whose bathroom am I in?
Janine remembered going to the party the night before and getting smashed out of her mind.
Barry remembered getting drunk and acting really stupid.
Eventually.
The whole evening came back.
Oh, I must be really stupid.
I must be really dumb.
What did I do? How did I get myself into this?
Well, what did I do? How did I get myself into this?
What about...
What about
AIDS? Then they both realized, much to their relief, that unlike the rest of us...
They were just cartoons.
Get high.
Get stupid.
Get AIDS.
Don't forget, now, you folks here in Southern California, join me on the radio every Sunday morning. Quiz FM 96.7 Santa Ana, Los Angeles. And we do the Wally George Great American Radio Special. So tune us in. We take a look at what's been happening in the news the past week. Do some VIP interviews. Look in the Wally mailbag. Play some cuts from my albums and other people's albums. It's making you a better American. Sunday mornings at 10 a.m., 96.7 Quiz FM. Tune in and turn on to Wally. And write to Wally. I'd love to get your letters. Here's my address, Wally George, P.O. Box 787, Hollywood, California, 90078. And be sure to get your Wally caps while they last. What a great present for Christmas here. Thanks for coaching me. I forgot what day it was. Wally George, P.O. Box 787, Hollywood, California, 90078. Only $26, including tax and postage and all that kind of stuff. And we'll get it out to you in time for Christmas. The Wally cap. It's going to be great. Oh, got to go now. God bless you all, and God bless America.
And now, stay tuned for the other voice of late-night television. Morton Downey Jr. is next, only on 56 KDOC. ¶¶